Okay, so here we have Elise, and she's got this beautiful, long, thick, red hair that we're going to create a panel cut. And the reason why we're going to create a panel cut on her is because we want to put the layers on the inside. Rather than typically layering the hair from the top, which would create a lot more expansion, what we want to do is we want to create more space so that the curls are freer and so that the shape collapses, but we really retain the curl within the hair. I'm going to work with a straight edge razor. The reason being, I can go from very short to very long. So it's going to enable me to really carve out a lot of hair and create a lot of space so that this hair can move. It's a very simplistic technique, but it's very structured. We're going to divide the hair up into 7 panels, and I'm going to show you exactly how we work in opposite fashions throughout the whole head so you can really create an internal layer technique that can be used very successfully on curly hair, but this is also a technique that can be done very successfully on straight hair. So let's get her shampooed, let's get the sections in there, and I'll walk you through step by step the panel cut. Come on. When doing the panel cut, the most important thing is to section the hair out consistently. This technique requires a lot of patience and diligence in getting the sections correct. Once you have the sections correct, it's going to be really easy to execute. Let's talk about the theory of what we're going to do. The first thing is we horseshoe and take the top of the hair and section that away. We're going to deal with the top at a later stage. We're then going to create 7 different panels. That's why we call this the panel cut. The first panel is to the top of the ear. The second panel is to the nape line. The third panel is consistent across, and the final panel is in the center. So what you're going to have to look for is you're going to have to look to create even sections throughout these panels. They've got to be consistent throughout. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take each of these panels and separately we're going to cut them. So each panel has a whole new guide. Typically speaking, I'm going to divide each panel into 2 sections, and I'm going to cut it in 2 sections. It's important that you have plenty of clips so you can work very cleanly with the hair. The haircut is completely the same on both sides. You will have to change body position slightly to accommodate for cutting both sides the same. But let's begin through the first panel. We always start through the front. And basically what we want to do is we are going to work from shortest, work out towards the length. So we're going to subdivide this panel into 2 sections. Nice and clean. You're going to have to work with the fine teeth of the comb so that you spread the hair out evenly and spread the hair out nice and fine. You need perfect tension so the fine teeth of the comb will deliver perfect tension. We don't want to pull this hair forward because it's going to create too short of an angle. So we want to pull this hair, comb it right from the base, and we're going to cut this hair from our shortest point at the cheekbone down to the longest point, and we're going to aim to the existing length that she already has. So nice, even tension, taking the razor, and now we're going to use an angle of the razor, nice even stroke, and we're going to very gently work down the hair, making sure that we don't create too much shred. If you have a look at what's in my fingertips, the hair that's been cut off, you'll see that that's a nice clean line. We're not creating too much shred because that will enable the curly hair to frizz. So we're going to continue to comb this hair down, working it around and using the edge of the blade to keep a cleaner finish on the hair, and I'm sliding through. You'll see if we look at that section one more time in our fingers, you can see how clean we can create that line. The idea here is we want to create space so that we see the face. If you remember before, she was covered in hair. Now what we want to do is we want to create a lot more looseness to the shape while still retaining a lot of length, and while encouraging the curl to have freedom and movement. You'll notice now I'm on my second section, we're over-directing the hair slightly forward, following through my guideline, I can just see it visually through here, and I'm going to put the razor in again using the edge, and I'm going to come straight the way down. My fingers are very slowly sliding through the hair. If you need to recomb, put the fine teeth of the comb back in, recomb, and work all the way out. Hair naturally will get finer towards the ends. And we are going to be putting in a lot of shape into this hair. That's our first panel cut. We're going to do exactly the same on the opposite side, but I'm going to continue on this side of the head so that you can clearly see how to create the panel cut. Once it's cut, section that hair totally away so it's never combed before. Once this panel's done, it's finished. I'll never check it. I'm now going to work to my second panel. And this is really where you start to get the idea of what we're doing here. We're cutting on the first panel from short to long, working down from top to bottom. On the second panel, we're going to go exactly opposite. We're going to work from short in the nape, working out to length through the top. So we're going to be creating this type of an angle through the haircut. What this is going to enable is it's going to enable me to get a lot more freedom in the curl and create a lot more movement. So we take the second panel down. We have our section there. It's a little too thick to cut it all in one go. So we subdivide. Remember, we're going to subdivide each of these segments. If you look at the hairline, you'll see it's relatively weak. So we're going to work from this shortest point, and I'm going to work this all the way out to the length. So we're going to take this section in two, use the rest of the head to keep the sections nice and clean. Don't take too much in your fingertips. It may end up being too much to manage. You can see we've got a lot more space here where we're just on the edge of the hairline. And you can also see I'm using the back of the blade so that I've got most of the blade away. And I'm going to work this motion upwards. I'm lifting the hair out at 90 degrees away from the head. Using the back of the blade, again, nice even strokes, working all the way up, again trying to achieve the existing length. So you'll notice I'm coming through, my fingers are sliding. Once we get to this point here, you can see we've cut that. We're going to take the top panel down, marry that in to the section that I'm cutting. And you can see that I can clearly follow through from that point. I can see the length in here, so I'm wanting to slide my fingers progressively through the hair so that I can create a nice, smooth transition from short in here to long through the top. Obviously, when you're working like this, you've really got to become very clean with your sectioning. You've got to be very organized. There's a lot less feeling in this haircut. It's much more of a structure rather than a feel. When we get to the end of the haircut, we're going to be putting in a little bit of personalization into the shape. But for now, we're really just focusing on structure. I've taken the second section of panel two. We're going to comb and place the top over the head because it's going to be too much to manage. And again, we're going to come through the nape. We're going to look and feel for our guide. It's just in through here. It's very light through here. You can't see it half as clearly because the hair is relatively fine. It's important to note that as you're working on these sections, you're really going to have to work very delicately to establish your guideline. Hair's certainly finer in certain parts of the head. Certainly behind the back of the ear, the hair can be quite fine. And I'm using the back of the blade and very gently working up, combing the hair out at 90 degrees and scooping the hair from the underneath, working upwards. Now we're going to take the top of that panel down. We're going to comb this all the way out so you can see we're retaining a lot of length through the shape. And we're going to continue to follow through. You could not do this haircut with a scissor. You need the fluidity of a straight edge razor to help you master and work through this haircut. As far as keeping length, you can certainly work to retain length. However, some length will be sacrificed in the cut. But you can certainly see here that we have at least, I would say, 12 to 14 inches of length retained. Once we've cut that second panel, we take it, we take the clip from the first panel. We scoop this hair nice and clean, and then we clip it out of the way. Now we're going to go to panel three. And if you really think about this cut, what you're going to see happen is it's just a combination of opposites. The first panel we cut from top to bottom. The second panel we cut from bottom to top. The third panel we now go back to the original way and we cut from top to bottom. Again, we're going to split this panel into two so that we can work to a cleaner guide. You can easily just comb this hair away and place it around the top of one of the clips. Try to keep your short lengths exactly the same. In other words, let's be consistent. If we're this short here, we should be that short in the nape. So you want to keep your short pieces consistent. Now we're pulling the hair out at 90 degrees. And again, we're going to come through with the top of the blade. And I'm just going to use the edge of the blade so as to create a clean line. See what you've got just poking through here. It's nice and clean. There's not a lot of shred in the hair. Now, when you're in this cut, what you're going to find is, you're going to find that you're going to maybe get a little nervous at a certain point. It's quite extreme to be taking out this much hair. You can vary your lengths depending on the density of the hair. With hair that curls, you tend to find that it expands greatly when dry. It's important to cut the hair wet, but it's also important to allow the hair to start to dry throughout the cut so you can actually see the expansion of the curl. And as we're coming through here, you'll notice that we're really managing to maintain a lot of the length. The existing length is right the way here, so we're real close to maintaining the existing length. Now we'll take our second section. You can pull this hair out at 90 degrees. You can see the guide through the hair. You can see where we start, right here. And I'm going to follow this section throughout. It's important at this stage of the game that you just stay in the moment. Don't worry about the finish. Just stay with the moment of working to get very balanced within these sections. Work nice and cleanly. Remember to work with the fine teeth of the comb. Remember to get right in at the root so you're getting perfect tension. And just be very systematic and very methodical as you start to work from the top down to the bottom. We're on panel three. And we're progressing through the cut nicely. I don't need to look at what the hair's doing at this stage of the game. I've worked out these panels perfectly around the head so that I know I will always maintain enough body weight and volume in the hair. You can just have a little look at that. We have the shortest piece and we have the length. The way in which we have to cut this panel is we are now going to go back to from short on in the nape out to length through the top. But the way in which we cut this panel, because this is on the center axis of the head, we're going to divide it down the center, split it right the way down the center of the back of the head, so you're bang in the center. Take this hair, clip that away. This side, we're going to rotate and come from underneath. And the opposite side, we're going to come the opposite way. But we're going to use the first side as the guide. So again, coming through, remembering how short your panel just was, That was about the starting length. Now we're going to come through from the underneath. And we're just going to use the edge of the blade so as not to shred the hair out too much. When hair's naturally very curly, you don't need to over-shred it. What we're doing here, we're working with a tool that's actually sharper than a scissor. So we're creating a very clean edge to the hair. And you'll notice that I'm really working upwards, wanting to maintain the length. When we came up with this technique, the idea was that we wanted to start layering hair on the inside, rather than just layering hair down from the top. And the inspiration came from looking through styling pictures of long hair and hairdressers creating movement with hair that was traditionally just one length. That's the first section of the center panel. Now I'm going to take the second section, and you're going to see I can't pull this hair in this way because that would be inconsistent. What you're going to see now is I'm going to pull the hair the opposite way. The chin's going to dip down just a little. So now we're going to comb it back using the original section as my guide. I'm going to subdivide it so as to keep the hair nice and clean. Section that out of the way. And now we're just going to come through the base, working with my existing guide. And this time, you'll see that I've had to change my angle to stay and remain consistent with the cut. But I'm doing exactly the same as I did on the first section. The cut doesn't take long once you've actually got the panel set into place. So what we've got is we've got space because the underneath's shorter and the top falls over. We have now completed one full side of the panel cut. And now we are going to begin and do the exact same on the opposite side. So we have three panels left to cut. We come to the opposite place, combing the hair down and around, not just forward, but more down and around and creating a scooping effect. So I'm going to continue with the remainder of the panels. And once we've finished, then we'll drop everything down and have a look what we've created. Okay, now we've cut the underneath, now let's tackle the top. So for safety reasons, and to keep it nice and clean, we're going to clip everything out. Now I'm going to drop this top section down, I'm going to resection, and then we'll get back into the cut and I'll explain exactly what's happening. We're going to section down the center of the back of the head. Right the way through the center. We've split the top into two. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take a section from the back, about an inch in from the back, and we're going to come to over the ear. We're going to create some new panels for us to cut. Let's twist it so we can see it nice and clear. The next panel, and she does have some pre-existing bangs. So we're not going to work to this length, but we want to keep the length in there. We're now going to take this, and we're going to come right the way through to the front of the head. Again, working to maintain about an inch through the very top of the head. So you want to have literally about an inch here and about an inch here. And we're going to repeat that on the opposite side. We've dropped down the horseshoe and we've created a diamond section. So we now have four new panels. One either side at the front, one either side through the back. You're always going to have more hair through the back because there's obviously a lot more hair there than there typically is through the front. We're going to drop these panels down and we're going to cut them. And we're going to take these two sides, and we're going to keep them parallel to the section, but we're going to cut from short in the center out to length and out to length. Because of the bang, we don't have any length in here. So we're really going to be creating a nice deep concave through this side. And then we're going to repeat exactly the same on the opposite side. If the hair's not too thick, you can take it in one section. So here, we're going to come through, keeping the sections nice and parallel. And this really is a perfect place to put a shorter piece because it's going to support the hair. It's going to give the face more lift because this area here is right on the axis of the bend. So we're going to get a lot more lift throughout the shape. So now we're going to work exactly the same using the edge of the blade to come all the way out to the front. Through the back, I'm going to subdivide this into two because that section's too thick. So we're just going to subdivide it into two. We'll rest that length over there. We'll pick everything up. The underneath is sectioned out. We can pick up a little piece of the short through here. And now we're going to come through from the shortest point, which is right in here, using the edge of the blade. So we get a nice clean line. We don't want to create too much frizz in this hair. And just working through, working to the pre-existing length. So this is a great technique to reduce bulk and to retain length. Also a fantastic technique for creating space within the hair so that the hair will curl in its natural form. And you get much more of a editorial type of finish because the hair doesn't look overly layered. And we've managed to retain all of that length through the back, which will also add to the volume and the thickness that everybody really needs when they layer their hair. So we've got plenty of hair that's going to fall over some of those shorter pieces that has been cut on the underneath. Once we've completed one side, we then go to the opposite side and do exactly the same. Remembering to keep that nice and straight, so your comb should be parallel, should just rest there. And now we're going to work again from the inside, same level of shortness, using the edge of the blade. Again, through this back section, we're going to subdivide it into two. There's too much hair to manage in one go. So we come through, we have our shortest piece. Now we're going to use the back of the blade, but still just using the edge. And just coming through. The space that we're creating in here, we're going to fill in with our next section. We're going to create the same type of effect, but we're going to do a complete opposite. And what that's going to do is that's going to enable the hair to fall into the space that we're creating right now. Okay, once that's been done, we just resection the hair. Let it right down the center to two halves. And then we're going to create another triangle. It's the first half. It's the second. So we can keep that out of the way. I'm going to do exactly the same on this side. Head down just a little. Thank you. Keep your sections nice and clean. Have a good comb. You can get a nice clean section with a great comb. Section it out. And you'll see what we're left. We're left with another small diamond through the top. We're getting real close to the finish of our haircut. Now, we are going to do the complete opposite of what we just did. On the last panel, we cut this way. Now we're an inch higher. We're now going to cut this panel the opposite way. And I'm going to use the back of the blade again to work through the edge. And just a nice clean, you can see how clean this is. It's the existing length. We're going to see if we can just about get there. Now, if you think about this length here, this length is directly above the short piece. So this length that we're just left is going to fall over the shortest piece that we just created. So we're going to fill in the gaps. That's what we talk about when we say we're creating space. I'm now going to come do exactly the same on the opposite side. We can pinch this hair forward. Working out the way, all the way out to the pre-existing length. So now what we've created is we've created the length on either side that will fall in over the space that where we cut the shorter hair. Now I'm going to come to the back and do exactly the same as we did through the front. So we're just going to take this final diamond, this is the top panel, we're going to split it directly into two, down the center, and we're going to repeat the exact same as we did when we first started working through the top. So we're going to create a nice steep concave through here, working from short to long, from short to long. It's important when you're on the very top that you don't cut the shortest point anywhere close to the top of the head. Be over the head so that when the hair shrinks, it doesn't shrink up too short. So this final panel, we can cut in one section, coming over the head, a little bit more length for security, and just coming right the way through again and slicing all the way out to the length. You see, we've taken a lot of hair out. We'll just double check to make sure we got it all. You should be able to clearly see the space that's been created. Now we'll do the same on this side. So now let's shake the hair around a little. So the hair is going to feel a lot lighter. There's a lot less hair there than there was before, but we've still managed to maintain a lot of length, but we have this undulation and this freedom in the curl. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to now slowly start to comb the hair around. I'm going to come through the bangs. I'm just going to refine the bang, the existing bang, just a little, and then we're going to style. I just want to break up the bang area a little. It's a little too thick. To break it up, we don't want to shred the ends out. All you want to do is you want to come in and just mirror what you have been doing. Cut a little bit of space in there. You see, you can get a nice amount of space with a razor. And just keep it consistent, just again coming through with the edge, creating a little bit of space so that we have as much space as possible for the hair to curl and to be free. Just in here again, little bit of space. I'm going to come to the opposite side. A little bit of space again. We're going to spritz it with a little bit of water, ready for the product application. We're going to place the volume foam into the hair. I'm going to use a good amount of pumps, about 6 pumps of volume foam. Work it into your hands. The reason why I like a foam is because it's going to be nice and light. It's going to be really easy to get into the hair. And we're just working this hair through. Nice and light, working it through the hair. This is going to help to lock the curls together. It's going to give us a light hold. And you're going to work it right the way through. And it's best to apply to create great curls. You have to apply the product to damp hair. It has to be in that hair and saturated throughout. Now, she has a lot of nice natural curl. We could use the curl cream, but for my feeling is I don't need to encourage it because the curl's been encouraged by the haircut. So we're actually going to use hair cream, which is going to add a lot of moisture to the hair. Don't be scared of using a decent amount of product. Rub it right the way through. This is nice and light. And we're going to work it through the underneath first so we get most of the product into the bulk of the hair. And then finally, the remainder can be worked through the top. Twist in and get in to push that product right into the hair. You've got to push the product in. We're now going to use the wide teeth of the comb to really make sure that we've got it right the way through the hair. Don't be scared of curly hair. It's important that you work the product into the hair. The curl will just come directly back once the hair starts to dry. I'm just going to comb that right the way through. Once we feel like we've really got the product into the hair, then we're going to allow the curls to form themselves. We don't need to overdo it. We just need to let the hair do the talking and let the product encourage the curls to stick together. It's very difficult to see where the layers begin and where the layers end. And that's why we think this technique is a great technique for a young, modern style, especially if you have a lot of hair but you want to encourage the curl. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to place a diffuser into the hair. So I'm going to spend the next 10 minutes just naturally lifting this hair, not scrunching, just lifting to enable the hair to get through. Low speed, high heat. Okay, so we've dried the shape. We used a little bit of holding spray just to give us even a little bit more sheen and definition. We take the cape off. You can see how great she looks and how great the razor has enabled us to free up the texture. If we spin around and just have a look, you can see this wonderful undulating curl. She's actually lost a lot of weight in the hair. She's got a really unique shape because we've really taken out hair from the inside. This is using the panel cut to create layers internally, gives us the freedom of the curl, but it also gives us a much more modern shape because we're not layering the hair from the top down. She still has plenty of hair. This can also be worn very nicely smooth, but I think it's just a fantastic job. And I think just to show that the razor can really help to encourage curl rather than to destroy curl. Enjoy your new look, okay?